हेलो एवरीबॉडी, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर जयदीप पटेल, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर आईटी डिपार्टमेंट एसआईआरटी भोपाल। वी विल स्टडी कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क। सो दिस लेक्चर विल बी इन कंटिन्यूएशन विथ प्रीवियस लेक्चर। एनआईसी इज अ हार्डवेयर कंपोनेंट यूज्ड टू कनेक्ट अ कंप्यूटर विथ अनदर कंप्यूटर ऑन टू अ नेटवर्क। It can support a transfer rate of 10, 100, 1000 Mbps and much more. These are the transfer rates. And the MAC address or physical address is encoded on the network card chip, which is assigned by the IEEE to identify a network card uniquely. It means that the address will be unique on the network of the network interface card. Now, how it looks like? This is the NIC. This is port. This is PCI connection. And this is it whole it looks like. Now, types of NIC, wired NIC and wireless NIC. The wired NIC is present inside the motherboard. And second one is wireless NIC. The wireless NIC contains the antenna to obtain the connection over the wireless network. For example, laptop, computer contains the wireless NIC. Now, hub. Hub is a hardware device that divides the network connection among multiple devices. When computer requests for some information from a network, it first sends the request to the hub. Then hub will broadcast that request to the entire network, and then appropriate device will respond. Nowadays, the use of hub is obsolete, means out of fashion. It is replaced by other components like switches, routers, etc. Now it is a hub. Now this computer wants to request something, then it will send the request to the hub, and then this request will be broadcasted to all the computers on this network. And then appropriate will respond. This is the working of hub. Now, next one is switch. A switch is a hardware device that connects multiple devices on a computer network. A switch contains more advanced features than hub. What are these? Switch does not broadcast the message to entire network as like the hub. It determines the device to whom the message is to be transmitted. So by using the switch, it increases the speed of a network. Now this is the switch. Say this computer wants to send this information to this computer, then this computer will send request to that switch, and switch will to forward this request to only that computer, not to all the computers on the network. That is the basic difference between the switch and a hub. This is the original switch, how it looks like. Okay. And next one is modem. A modem is a hardware device that allows the computer to connect to the internet over the existing telephone line. It stands for modulator demodulator. It converts the digital data into an analog signal over the telephone lines and vice versa also. This is the modem. Okay. Now next one is router. A router is a hardware device which is used to connect a LAN with an internet connection. It is used to receive, analyze and forward the incoming packets to another network. A router forwards the packet based on the information available in the routing table. Basic functionality of router means it finds the best path from the available path for the transmission of a packet. So packet should take less time and less longer path. This is the router you might have seen in home or offices. Now next one is cables and connectors. Cables are used for carrying the signals sent from nodes in the network. Now types of cables: twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, fiber optic cable. This is the coaxial cable. This is the twisted pair cable. This is the fiber optic cable. It is used nowadays. Now, connectors. Connectors are also known as plugs, acts as a terminating endpoint of the telecommunication cable. Connectors are used for connecting the cable to the device. These are the connectors. You might have seen back of your computer or in computer labs. Now, next one is broadcast network. What is a broadcast network? A computer network which has a single communication channel. A packet sent by one computer is received by all the other computers on the network. It means that whenever the packet will be transferred, it will be on a shared channel. It will be on a common channel. And all the nodes on that network will have the access for that channel. Radio stations are a good examples of broadcast network. Now, this is the diagram of a broadcast network. Router A sending the packet, it will be received by all the host on this network, and they will be sharing the common channel. So what is written here? The router in this network sends a broadcast packet, which is received and processed by all the hosts on the network. Now, next one is point-to-point network. A simple point-to-point network is a permanent link between two endpoints. The entire capacity of the link is reserved for transmission between those two devices. It means that two devices will be connected by a single link, so nobody can use that link. Most point-to-point connections use an actual length of a wire or cable to connect the two ends. But other options are also available, like such as microwave or satellite links. These are also possible. What are the benefits? It provides speed, security, and accessibility. Example of a point-to-point connection is telephone line. Now, this is the example of a point-to-point connection. Two nodes are connected via link. Thank you.